Good afternoon. Welcome to Matt's Clinic with Body News. Today we are looking at something very, very important. Let me remind you, if you have not been following us on Facebook, you may not be able to see all these videos. Go on Facebook and follow us. Follow us on YouTube at Matt Clinic with Body News. Today we are looking at something very important, and it is indices. We are going to be looking at the first law of indices. This topic is going to be in series, so as we started, we are going to continue that way. So when next you'll be seeing me on your screen, you're going to be seeing me with second law of indices. Today we are looking at first law of indices, which is the multiplication law. Look at how it is stated. Multiplication law states that if I have a number or a variable raised to a certain number, and I'm multiplying that same variable. Don't forget, that same variable, it shouldn't be a different variable. That same variable with, by itself, raised to another quantity, then the result will be this. Let's go in a very simple or a layman way. What we are saying is this, that if I have a number here, the number is X, and the same number is here. Look at it. X and X look alike. X and X are the same thing. So we are talking about the same number, not different numbers. The same number. This law is not saying that I multiply this number by this number. When you look at it clearly, you see that this one is X, this one is Y. So this law doesn't apply for this kind of expression. It only applies for an expression that is for the same or equal number. So clearly, you are going to follow me as I look at this with you. Now look at it. We have x raised to the power m times x raised to the power m. Emphasis x. When they are xx, then this law will hold. When once they are not xx, the law will never hold. Look at it. X raised to the power m times x raised to the power m. What this law is telling us is that I will pick one of the x and add up the power. Clearly, if you are multiplying, you will be adding up the power. The powers. When you multiply, you add up the powers. So what is that saying? Let's look at this example. Example 1. If I'm given 5 raised to the power 3 times 5 raised to the power 2, this law is saying, look at it, call this one your x. That means you have x raised to the power 3, call this one x, because they are the same thing, x raised to the power 2, look at it now. So the law can hold, because this is x, this is x, this is 5, this is 5. So the law can hold. What does that mean? The law says I should pick one of them. So here I'm going to pick one of the x, that means here I'm going to pick one of the 5. Can you see it now? So I'm going to pick one of the 5s. Then the law now says I'm going to take the powers and add them up. So I'm going to sum up the powers now. So I'm going to add 3 plus 2. And clearly, 5 will be equal to 5 raised to the power 5. Because 3 plus 2 is 5. Can you see that now? That the law is telling us that when I multiply a certain number by itself, I'm going to add up the powers. Now look at this again. Look at this example. If I'm going to, let's take another number now, say 3 raised to the power 2 by 3 raised to the power 7. The law says that if they are the same, I will pick one. If they are not the same, don't pick one. But if they are the same, pick one. So I'm going to pick one of them. And what do I do to the power? Because it is multiplication, I'm going to add up the power. So I'm adding up the power. I'm going to have 2 plus 7. And 2 plus 7 is 9. So I have 3 raised to the power 9. So look at it. Very simple. That is what the first law of indices tells us. But if I may ask you, I would want you to work with some of this. Try on your own and do this. Section. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, follow us on YouTube, and also invite your friends, share this video with them, And if you can do that, you will see that our math life will improve generally. Thank you. Welcome once again to Math Clinic with Paulinus.